Water is life, so the saying goes. It is important for communities to have access to clean water for better health. Chancellor College, the largest constituent college of the University of Malawi, incorporates teaching, research, and community outreach as its core mandates. As one way of community engagement, the college implemented a research project called Capacity Building in Geophysics in Malawi, which was aimed at mapping groundwater supply in the Lake Chilwa Basin. The project was implemented through the Department of Geography and Earth Sciences.
The aim of the project is to map groundwater supply in the Lake Chilwa Basin. We are looking at quantity of groundwater in terms of its availability, as well as the quality of the groundwater supply in this region. It is a project that is being funded by the Geoscientists Without Borders, a US-based organization, and it's an international research project that we are implementing as University of Malawi, together with Illinois University in the US and the Illinois State Geological Survey in the US. The project has a number of components. One of the components is to bring about knowledge and evidence regarding spots and locations for possible sources of groundwater supply in this area. And the second component is to build capacity in the geosciences. And to realize this component, the project is funding master's students in water resources, majoring in water governance and hydrogeology. These are based at the University of Malawi at Chancellor College in the Department of, in the Faculty of Science, rather. Apart from the research and capacity building, we are also benefiting from this project in terms of curriculum review. This project funded a curriculum review for our water resources program at master's level. And as we are talking now, because of that review, we have introduced two new programs. The first one is Master's in Water Resources, majoring in hydrogeology. And the second one is Masters of Science in Water Resources, majoring in Water Governance. So these are coming as components under this project.
The researchers in the project were excited with the findings they made, and they believed this will form a basis on which the lives of people in various communities will be uplifted.
The results are interesting. We are still analyzing the data. But one striking feature is that we have been able to identify spots or locations using the geophysics equipment that we are using in this particular project. I should also mention that we have also received state-of-the-art geophysics equipment that we are using in the analysis and assessment of the groundwater supply in this, in this area. So the results, we are still analyzing them. But on the basis of the what we have been able to identify locations that we think have got water availability. If we look at the aquifer qualities, and we have also been able to identify spots that, in from the analysis, are showing probably low water supply.
Chancellor College believes this project is a good example of what its core mandates are all about because it incorporates teaching, research, and community outreach at once.
Chancellor College, as you know, is a public institution. We do teaching, research, and community outreach. So within our portfolio of research, we had this project, a hydrophysics project, where the Department of Geography within the Faculty of Science was carrying out this critical project, interviewing people on various aspects of water and land use. Within there, they noted that there is a very big problem insofar as water is concerned. And they put boreholes as part of the critical aspects in terms of community outreach. So within our project with the University of DNA in the US, we managed to come up with four boreholes. We have one here and four other places that we are constructing these particular boreholes. This is an aspect of our community outreach because we know that we live within the community. We do research within this particular community and we want to have our community's well-being and welfare taken care of. That's why we put this component within the particular project that we are carrying out.
In addition to the fulfillment of these core mandates, the college believes the project also sharpened different skills within the communities.
The college has multiple facets in terms of its work. So you're looking at teaching, research, as well as outreach. So this, in a way, addresses those components, mainly the research. So you can see that this is, in part, a research project. But out of the research that's being conducted here, you have an actual work in terms of impact within the community. So in a way, interfacing research as well as the actual activities or action within a community. So this goes back also to feed into the day-to-day teaching of activities, because I think the theory is one thing, but translating theory into action within communities, and not just doing that, but in collaboration with people, entails a lot of things. You need different kinds of competences and disciplines. So there's the hard science or the pure science aspect, but you also need other soft skills in terms of community engagement or governance aspects. So those, in a way, will also go back to feed into the actual day-to-day teaching, as well as advancement of research and further development of theory as well.
It has been an exciting experience in the sense that we have been working with these communities from the word go. Even when we are doing the mapping, we are also working with the local communities. We have been interacting with the village development committees, we have been interacting with the tradition, the village headmen, we have also been interacting with the village development committees in these communities. So it is exciting to them, because I do remember that one of the researchers, one of the community members, when we met last time, she was saying that she's excited in the sense that research is able to bring an impact to the community. And these are the messages that we are getting from the community. And for us, we look at it as a big contribution, because we are looking at a research that is not only generating knowledge, but also feeding back to the communities that we are working with.
The people of Kim Village, in the area of traditional authority Mwambo in Zomba District, are among the many beneficiaries of this project. A borehole was sunk in the village as part of the project's output.
We are here today to implement a fourth component of this project, and this is now making a contribution to the communities that we have been working with. These are communities that are water stressed. These are communities that have problems in terms of accessing water, and you may be aware of the fact that the lecturer region is one of the regions that is having problems in terms of access to water. So this component, apart from training students, funding students, generating knowledge, reviewing the curriculum, we are also contributing in terms of drilling boreholes to three villages that we have been working in. And then we are also rehabilitating one borehole in one of the villages that we are working on as a contribution to the communities that we are working with in the Chilwa Basin. We are targeting four villages, namely Kim, where we are today, and there is also another village, Likapa, as we are going to the lecture area. And there are two villages, Jimutu, around the Jali area, just at the foot of Chanda Hill. And the other village is Kuchirimba, just in the Chanda Hill area.
Community members from Kim Village are very grateful for the new borehole and have pledged to use it sustainably.
Ndiyamika kuchasa kuliji, chifuwa chuti bwedesera jigo meneu, pamenda kampira poyamba kutunali pa mavuto akulu. Ndipo paipa tineu kutita mangobali, asasire sopopa. Ngatipali zitu kukuzina ndizina, aya nea kutimuna makesu atitandize, mpavu zose zimene zika hakuwa ine ngatifumu ngatisogoleri, meme za antwanga. Kutichonde tisaunongi jigo u, fuapo yamba tinali pa mavuto amazi tinali ndi jiko mozi ndeta pesekani mijiko iwiri tirosangala kwambiri okuti ndipangisa sonkhano kuti anthu anga osamene ndiaziwise kuti jiko mene utusamalire usaonongekeso kuti akuti ife jiko utusamalira ndipo amene ofuna kuononga kubwera ndi mavuto pa jiko mene usiziteka china chili chose ife tigonjesa china chili chose ndioti ife yoti takhaleje kumbali yajani ya alendo amene atigubira jiko awo apadera ofuna kuti onongera ntchito ife titapangeso kuti tiagonjese anthu amene chili chose chimakhala ndi umwini jiko undu wa ife anthu amuzi mwakimu ndete ne akusamalira wina aliyense amene ofuna kuchita chipongwe pa jiko mwe sizingatheke ife apa jiko patisakhapo komiti kuti ikhale yang'ania jiko kuti tisamalire kuti tizimwa madzi abwino komanso tizikhala ndi zipangizo zabwino zapa jiko.
The project also sunk another borehole in Kujilimba village, and chairperson for the water point committee in the village said the new borehole has reduced the distance which they had to travel to get potable water.
Jigo mene utuwa chepisa mavudo, chuyambi yaso tikatokozi ya chasa koleji chifuwa joti ganizira kuno kwa Kujilimba, watichepisa la mavudo. Koti ife anduwa muzimuno mazi timamua kusenda ya kwa blea, pasenda hapo mwafika hapo, mbibameti makatunga ife mazi. Ndiyo kubela kwa jigo mene utukuzua kuti ife amai, timasuka kumaso tijaba, kumaso tisamba, kumaso ngakari ya zibambo, sazavaa maaya kula la yokuda, azao nekabunuwa chifuwa cha jigo mene. Jigo mene kutandiza mabanja 35, amuzimuno mwa Kujilimba. Jugomene utusa magwa mbili potengela komiti tipo teni kugwira ntchito mogwirizana komaso mopasirana ndikulandizana kuti jigo athu zienda bwino tizimwa amazi abwino.
Chancellor College says this is not the end but the beginning of several other research projects and interventions that would benefit communities such as those in the Lake Chilwa Basin.
We limited the research to the Lake Chilwa Basin, but we know that Lake Chilwa Basin for us, for Chancellor College, we take it as our laboratory, and there is a lot of work that we still plan to do in this area. That goes beyond even scaling up to reach out even to other communities. There could be other areas of research that we'll be brainstorming so that we can expand the research to tackle even other areas that are affecting the communities here in the Lake Chilwa Basin.
In addition, the college intends to upscale the delivery of messages and capacity development in such projects.
Going forward, we would want this engagement to continue. I think part of that has already been done in terms of engagement to identify the site for the borehole. So we've worked with the community and the chief, and they were in the forefront in terms of identifying where the borehole should be sunk. And I think going forward, we would also work in terms of different areas of capacity development, because they know their social context much better. But also in terms of the theoretical aspects, I think we were versed in that. So this is a relationship that can be mutually beneficial in terms of both parties. And I think one thing that I was discussing with colleagues when the borehole was being sunk is that, okay, maybe there's also need for another component in terms of packaging the message. That, okay, you saw the kids that were witnessing that, what message do they get out of this? Okay, if you ask them what would they want to become in future based on this, will they just say, okay, I want to be someone who sinks boreholes, or they'll get the deeper message behind this, that there are different other competences or complexities in terms of getting to that point. Let's say the geographical aspects or geophysics aspects. So I think there's also need to go beyond this and unpack the various areas of expertise that go into this kind of work, so that they're able to appreciate those, you know, areas of competence and their profession based on the activity that was being done today.
Satisfied with the program, the University of Illinois said Malawi should expect more projects from the partnership, which will continue uplifting the well-being of different communities.
With these boreholes, this is the last of the major objectives. We've been able to revise the master's thesis program there, so that's helping to develop the program. Three students are completing their master's program, so that's helping the students, and now the humanitarian benefit of providing these boreholes to the villages. They should expect a follow-on from this partnership in that the capacity is improved from the department, so that they're now equipped to provide other sorts of projects and also to help other students and to go on further with their studies and with humanitarian efforts throughout the area.
The project may have phased out, but the outcomes are there to be used from now and for generations to come.